So the next thing is on how to add dynamic zoom on a particular clip. So let's say we have this clip selected and we have its properties in the inspector panel over here. And you can see among the properties, you have the dynamic zoom over here. So once you click to enable it, you can see you have the different features in the dynamic zoom. You can see this is linear. You can do ease in, ease out, and ease in and out at the same time. So you can swap as well. So instead of easing, you can ease out. So this is a very small clip. So let's say we enable dynamic zoom and it's going to be linear. So let's try to have the effect. So look at the, from the beginning of the clip to the end of it, it zooms out, okay? Zooms in and zooms out. So let's try to have it in preview and see what it does. So you can see gradually it is moving in the background. Okay, it is easing out. Okay, from the way it started, you can see it is easing out and you can now see me very clearly as it is out. So to see it very clearly, you have to just move in a bit faster. So this is it and this is the easing out. This is the easing in and this is the moving in and then moving out. So gradually as I'm explaining the concept, it is increasing or it is zooming in and it is zooming out. Zooming out directly is for you to see me clearly. You can swap in as well the effect. You can swap and make it, instead of zooming out, it's going to zoom in accordingly. So right now it is zooming out. So once we swap, it's going to start zooming in. Okay, so once we enable the swap, you can see it is now zooming in. Okay, you can see me very clearly, unlike at the beginning of the clip. Okay, this is now zooming in. And you can change it as well to either ease in and out accordingly from here. So this is how to add dynamic zoom in your clip within DaVinci Resolve. And one last thing that I would like to show us within the panel is how to play around with the view of the panel. So to play around with the view of the panel, this is a timeline option, timeline view option. Once you click on this, you will have the option to, this is a timeline option. Once you click on it, you have the timeline view options, you have the video view options, you have the audio view options. You can play around with all of them from here. So for example, let's say the timeline view option, this is how it is interconnected between the links. You can click and you can see, you will not be able to see the waveform in the audio, or you can enable to see it, or you can disable it just like so. And you can disable, you can play around with the timeline view over effect also over here, and you can enable it to be something like this, or with and without the waveform. The video view options also, you can change it from this normal one to the thumbnail one, but only at some locations. And you can have the complete video without the thumbnail view as well. So just something like this, without the picture or without the frame rate, without thumbnail view within the video clip. Or you can have it, I think I prefer it this way, so you can have a preview of the thumbnail of the video part of the clip, what is it all about and what you can do. So the same thing goes to the audio view options. You can have it with the audio shown in one way just like so, or you can have it shown in two ways, okay, some like multi-stereo, and you can have it in the line format over here as well. So you can change accordingly. And down here you can play around with the sizing. This is for the video. You can increase the sizing or you can decrease the sizing as well if you so wish. So you can see it now becoming very clearly. And with the audio as well, you can increase or decrease the sizing as well just from here. So you have these very controls to yourself to play around with accordingly at any given point. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.